Okay, good. Okay, and then it's my great pleasure to introduce the next talk by Professor Ashyralyev. And he will give a talk about bounded solutions of semilinear, fractional, Schrodinger differential and difference equations. Could you please start?
Please turn on your microphone. Your microphone is off.
Yeah, I can hear.
No, I mean Professor Ashyralyev. His microphone is off.
Oh.
Fine. No problem.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, sorry. I did not recognize that today. Yeah. Is it okay?
But how about not working my man?
Microphone? Hmm?
Okay. You listen to me?
Yes, we hear you.
Now everything okay?
I can hear you. Can hear you.
Yes, everything is okay. Go ahead.
Okay, first of all, I would like great thanks for my friend Mikhail Ruzevsky for such type activity. It is very good, like drug, because in this hard time, isolation not good for us and everybody. Now to be together in workshop, it is very important. But before starting my talk, all this talk, I understand physical minimum. I remember Dmitry invited me 2007 Chankara University for my talk. I interested with fractional spaces and structure fractional space. And first time I meet with committee fractional calculus in Chankara University. And I asked two questions, simple question, and after that I find answer and a lot problem for my investigation in this area. And 1950, I give a server paper about this type of investigation connected with operator theory in conference Tashkent, which one devoted Academy Galimova. So it was pleasure to meet also people in Central Asia and discuss about this subject. But today I think not easy for talk, which type problem for my interest. But before and today also big my interest about stability theory, high order accuracy, difference schemes for solving partial differential equations. This is my main subject. Really, I interested this self-adjointness and also different problem, but all my concentration subject varies. Maybe not easy use the classical techniques like maximum principal energy method, and maybe also sometimes no way uses such type of techniques. And in these cases, we will using techniques, operator calculus, and so all my concentration varies problem operator dependent, no using like integral transform techniques, and maybe also non-local problems. So problem is uses such type of object. So Today I will talk joint our paper with my former PhD student Betül Hiçturmaz. In this discuss, this is a discuss on the initial value problem semilinear fractional integral differential equation in Hilbert space H with self-adjoint positive definite operator A. Here we can constructed first and second order accuracy difference schemes for the approximate solution differential problem. And we get here theorems existence, uniqueness, bounded solution, semilinear differential problem, and also differences problems generated by these different schemes. In practice, I want to consider two problems. One-dimensional simpler problem with non-local conditions, also multidimensional classical, maybe the respect condition. But here, main idea to show how working our this theory. And we can find here theorems about uniqueness, existence uniqueness theorem for bounded solution, initial value problem for one-dimensional and multidimensional problems. So last part for nonlinear equation problem with numerical results. So we give some illustration examples, one-dimensional and multidimensional problems to show how validation of theoretical results. So contents my talk. I will give brief introduction and also what I get second section fractional Schrodinger integro-differential equation. But our interest construction absolutely stable difference schemes, usually second order, high order, but here we will construct it and investigate it first and second order accuracy difference schemes. So three first order accuracy difference schemes, after that four modified Kranke-Nicholson difference schemes, five section second order accuracy implicit difference schemes. After that, numerical results, one dimensional and two-dimensional case. After that, conclusion and some plans for maybe leasing, maybe some of the people interested such type problems. It will be nice for communication with you. I formulate problem with my team. So recent years, fractional calculus paves the way for science in various field model. They are nonlinear phenomena more precisely. Here I put here some reference, but number four, why I put, because starting with first time, I want to see what relation between fractional power and also fractional power and fractional derivative. So here some literature I put these techniques permits in new application spheres for fractional equations, population dynamics, imaging process, acoustics, electromagnetism, signal process, information science, communication, etc. So here also I put very maybe selected very important papers, but not here all. It is impossible to give here service. However, modern real world problems in differential equation Modeling the real world problems, differential equation forms arise necessary for exact approximate solution of these differential problems. It is well known that nonlinear problems are difficult to handle with AC analytical and numerical approaches. Fractional Schrodinger problems appear in different studies with fractional order derivative in time, space, both directions. Nonlinear fractional Schrodinger problems are studied many papers, including but not limited. Furthermore, papers on physical properties of fractional Schrodinger equation prove the strong relation mathematical improvement and physical phenomena they referred here, 16 and 19. Also not here, not all here, many papers. However, the time fractional nonlinear problems are studied rarely in the literature. Also, I put here, implement methods include meshless techniques, matrix functions, finite element methods, Lie group analysis method, and so on. However, finite differences schemes are not investigated well for nonlinear time fractional Schrodinger equation. In the paper on finite differences methods for linear fractional Schrodinger equations, fractional derivatives appear in the space variable. Also here, these papers. It is known that classical numerical techniques like finite difference methods possess the importance due to their well-posedness theory and useful property like stability. Also, I put here reference connected these subjects. Multidimensional problems arise in real world problems frequently. But for us and motivation hours, starting with paper 35, is one of rarest studies of higher order approximation nonlinear two dimensional fractional Schrodinger equations. 35. In recent publication, stability of initial boundary value problem for linear fractional Schrodinger differential equation are studied with different approaches. Here some reference. However, the non-linearity terms, problem one, into the challenge one. Okay. Now, but last paper, but this is PhD thesis. Long time we interested fractional Schrodinger equation, but usually our interest construction high order approximation formula for linear Schrodinger equations and also getting stability results. So, and also applications part, but this is linear problem and second motivation also start with this thesis. After our some investigation, we think what happens when we consider problem one, nonlinear terms. Here, right side involves fractional derivative order alpha, but since here zero doesn't matter, Liouville-Volcato here saying, in this paper, problem one investigated with both theoretical and numerical approaches. Besides this first order accuracy difference schemes, various second order accuracy difference schemes are presented. Since high order algorithms have great advantage in real world applications, the present paper fills the gap by presenting second order accurate approximation for n-dimensional non-linear fractional Schrodinger problem, this applying of operator approach. This is also one example also for non-linear problems. So next section, fractional Schrodinger integro-differential equation. Let A be Hilbert space, A positive definite self-adjoint operator, and we will introduce here operator function, strongly continuous exponential operator function, exponential function for t greater than zero. And for this operator function in H, we have estimate two. It is important for our discuss later. So we will consider here classical solution. Function ut is called the solution of one if the following condition satisfied. Ut is continuously differentiable and right side must be belongs to H for any t from segment zero t. The element ut belongs domain of E and the function AOT must be continuous. And UT satisfies the fractional differential equation and initial condition. The procedure of Prof theorem on existence uniqueness of bounded solution one is based on reducing this problem to an integral equation three. Okay. Integral equation three. But in H alpha is this is a space of abstract function defined on the zero with values H. We will use a successful approximation. Here H alpha is the Banach space consisting of all abstract functions having fractional derivative order alpha defined on zero t with value h for which following norms are finite. So however, also we introduce here space c alpha zero to h space obtained completion of all smooth h valid function wave of t on zero t in the norm, Hilbert norm. And C0TH standard the Banach space of continuous functions at T defined on the zero T with values H occupied with maximum norm. So we need formula for recursive formula for get using fixed point theorem. So we get here first order derivative. And after that, we define it here alpha order fractional derivative from solution. So you see, this is double integral, but involving this operator functions. So recursive formula solution one now define it next formula. Formula six. And main theorem 2.1 assumes the following hypothesis hold. The function f from zero to h alpha to h is continuous. That is estimate seven holders. And also Lipschitz condition A also holds. Here, okay, then there is exist unique boundary solution UT, problem 1-1 in H alpha. So here constants L and M bar, some positive constants here, and also later we will using these constants. And briefly proof, according the method of recursive approximation 6, we get series 9, and using the estimate and formula 9 and 7, and we get here estimates, we get two estimators for difference and but so for any t from that we can get estimate 10, which proves the existence of bounded solution UT, problem 1 in H alpha. The boundness first order derivative AUT after getting this results follow from equation and formula 4 and triangle inequality estimates 7 and 10. So this is end of proof. Now we will consider applicational abstract result to one-dimensional non-local and multidimensional local problems. First, the mixed problem semilinear functional Schrodinger equation is considered. Here, A of X must be positive and also satisfied here periodicity condition, and all compatibility condition must be satisfied. And we will consider L20L for H, and problem 11 we can consider as the problem 1 in H alpha with self-adjoint operator AX generated by problem 11. So from theorem 2-1 directly follows theorem 2-2. Assume the following hypothesis holds. The function f satisfied estimate 12 and 13, Lipschitz condition and boundness. Then there is exists problem 1 and which is bounded H alpha. The proof of this theorem is based on the abstract theorem 2-1 and symmetric property of operator AX generated by problem 11. Second example, multidimensional case. Let omega be the union open coup in the M-dimensional Euclidean space with boundary S. Omega bar is union omega and S. And in 0T omega, we will consider mixed problem for multidimensional semilinear functional Schrodinger equations. And we put here condition for coefficients operator and Rx greater than equal zero, and all compatibility condition must be satisfied. And in these cases, we can introduce our problem like abstract problem, and we can formulate now results for this problem, formulate like theorem 2-3. Okay, here. Here, one dimensional. I am very sorry. And here, problem is my computer. So I will now. Okay. One moment. I will make some correction with my documents, because here not good C. I am very sorry. Okay, now it is must be better. Very sorry, but I have problem with. So, two applications I consider, and now first order accuracy difference schemes. For the approximate solution of one, applying the set of grid points 17, we propose the first order accuracy difference schemes 18. In order to establish existence uniqueness theorem of the difference scheme 18 as discrete analogy theorem to 1, we introduce here h 1 alpha tau h 2 alpha r. This is normal space of all abstract functions having fractional difference derivative of alpha defined on 0 t with tau with values h, for which the following norms uniformly bound is with respect tau 19 and 20. Here, first order approximation formula for fractional derivative, next one, second order. And also, we will introduce here difference analogy, Hilbert space, and also C space. Now, again, we need formula for recursive formula. In this case, we have formula 23 for the solution, and here it is generated by operator function. Here R operator defined by 24, and we can get here formula for first order derivative, and it is ready now for recursive formula. For recursive formula, we will consider here difference schemes 27. So using 27 and 26, we can get 28 formula for recursive formula for getting results for nonlinear difference equations. Let the assumptions theorem 2-1 satisfied, then there is exact unique solution of difference scheme 18, which is bounded in H1 alpha tau of uniformly with respect to tau. So we will using idea, we will seek solution as a series, but we need estimate, and using estimates 30, we can get two estimate for any n. And after that, we get estimate directly right sides this series, and this is convergent, which is proves the existence bounded solution of difference scheme 19. This is bounded in this space uniformly with respect to tau. And now we will consider applications. Note that study of discretization our time only of the initial value problem also permit one to include general difference schemes in applications. If the differential operator A in the space variable are replaced by the difference operator A each, that that act in the Hilbert space, self-adjoint operator, and positive definite operator uniformly with respect to A. First, we consider one-dimensional problem 11. We will consider differential part, and discretization 11 provided in two steps. To the differential operator, first step, generating A, we assign the difference operator HX by formula 31, acting in the space of grid functions, satisfying conditions. These difference conditions. And with the help of now difference operator, we are at the initial value problem for ordinary fractional differential equation. And second step, we will using first order accuracy difference schemes for solving now problem 32. And this is difference schemes 33. And theorem 3.3, let the assumptions theorem 3.1 satisfied, then there is exists unique solution of difference schemes 33, which is bounded in this space uniformly with respect tau and h. Now here we put tau and h applications. The proof of this theorem based on the abstract theorem 3.1 and symmetry property of difference operator defined by formula 31. And second, initial value problem 14 for multidimensional Schrodinger equation consider. Now, here also two step. First step, approximation space operator. We consider here a symmetric operator and acting in the space of grid functions satisfying Dirichlet conditions in mesh points. So we get also problem one now in the space L2H. So we get now ordinary differential Cauchy problem for ordinary differential equation, and replacing it by first order differential schemes, we get for the numerical solution 36. And now similar results we have also for 36 under the condition theorems 3.1. So there is exist bounded solution of difference scheme 36 uniformly with respect tau and h. So the proof of theorem is based abstract theorem 3.1 and symmetric property of difference operator. And here also we need a correlativity theorem for elliptic difference operator in L2 spaces. So as before I talk, I interested high order. High order means here second order, because long time it was difficult problem getting second order formula, approximation formula. But here, first we will consider our modified Kranke-Nicholson difference schemes. So for the approximate solution, we will use the same mesh points, and we will consider 37. It consists of two part K from 1 to R and from K plus 1 to N. But right side defined 38, same for both difference schemes, but left side here first order approximation and second order. How we will construct it? We will first construct it here exact difference schemes generated by exponential function. After approximation, we get such type of formula, but for R 1, 2, 3, we have here second order also, because what a second. So I consider here second order approximation formula in this paper. And in order established theorem uniqueness, I must construct, but I must consider here nonlinear equation. How many time I have? And I need constructed here also recursive formula here. We get recursive formula by formula 36, but also for getting recursive formula, we need consider here 37. because linear part, we solving exactly nonlinear part, we using here iteration procedure. So we get a recursive formula denoting by not denoting here last this part I give. So here under the assumption theorem 2.1, we have a bounded solution difference scheme 30H, which is bounded in these spaces now only H to alpha. Note that similar manner in section 3, we can construct R modified Kronk and Nicholson difference schemes for approximate solution problem 11, 13. And so abstract theorem 31 permits us to establish theorem on the existence bounded solution, these difference schemes uniformly with respect to tau and H. Now, I consider implicit second order difference schemes, but if C are modified generated by A, here it is generated by A square. So it is really problem with computations in future. And using same idea, but now solution generated by pre-operator. It is generated by A square, A. So formula for solution, from formula solution, we can get formula for first order derivative, second order derivative. And using this idea, we get here fractional derivative from solution. And denoted by 51. Now for recursive formula, we will consider difference schemes 52, and now formula for solution 52 and formula 51 permit us to get here recursive formula for our investigation. And theorem 5.1, let the assumptions theorem 2.1 satisfy. Then there is exist unique solution. For both one dimensional and two dimensional case and uniformly with respect tau and h. Here we implement iterated first and second order accuracy difference schemes for one and multidimensional semilinear fractional problems. First, this is first, I difference schemes 18, 37, 48. For the approximate solution problem 54, we get system nonlinear equations. We get the solution of the problem. We convert the problem into the system of matrix, and we use the fixed point iteration and modify Gauss elimination method to deal with the matrix equation. Throughout the experiments, iteration starts with when k equals zero and terminate when error between each iteration becomes less than 10 power minus 7 in the given norm. So arrows defined at 55, and UKX represents the exact solution. UNK represents a terminated numerical solution at TKXN. Results here, one dimensional case like that. And as it is seen in table 1, table 2, and table 3, presented the arrows difference schemes. For alpha, three values, 0.25, 0.50, 0.71 respectively. Some numerical results are given. If n are doubled and m considered constant as m2050, the values of errors decrease by the factor approximately 1/2, for first order accuracy difference schemes, and the value error decreasing by factor of approximately 1/4 for the second order accuracy difference schemes. 37 and 38. And also we get similar results for two-dimensional case, choosing same alpha. So, and we get similar results. And first order, like 1 over 2, second order 1 over 4. And last part, I will consider here, what do you do in first part? I will now, but some part of these results publish it in this paper. And now a little bit about future plans. We are interested in studying uniform two-step difference scheme asymptotic formula for solution initial value perturbation problem in semilinear delay hyperbolic equation in Hilbert space H, self-adjoint post-definite operator with small parameter and high order derivative. So only we give such type investigation joint with Hector Fattorini during my stay in USA. Here problem with construction, but no way to use here classical difference schemes. And so using here exact difference schemes, we will consider here uniform difference schemes. And also we will consider here asymptotic formulas. This estimate very useful, some investigation, Hector Fattorini control problem, and I remember it. But second, investigation bounded solution identification problems, semilinear fractional Schrodinger integro-differential equation. But here, direct problem U00. Now we will consider UT equal phi, because here, unknown param identification problem, space variables. We have linear problem. Several paper with my PhD student Urun. So it is also a problem in future. Investigation bounded solution initial value problem semilinear fractional Schrodinger integral differential equation time delay. So what we will consider here? Last time several paper about application and theory Schrodinger equation delay, this time delay. So I put one paper here, but I think approach of this paper can be maybe investigation in this area also. And we are interested in studying boundness solution initial value problem involutory semilinear fractional Schrodinger integral differential equation. But here involutory with respect T, really this is differential equation involution time variables. So we have here some investigation also, but we all our investigation firstly stability, but we will study positivity, stability. Stability for problem one, linear case, studied by my colleagues. And this is end of my talk. Thanks for attendance. I am very sorry for my, okay, but now ending. Professor
Yamamoto.
No.
Probably he's disconnected.
I'm here.
Ah, okay. Yeah. I think it is finishing his talk.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Do you have any questions or comments? Okay, maybe just one question. Is there some error analysis of your scheme?
I don't understand your question.
Okay, the inequality or estimate between the exact solution and your approximate solution.
Ah, Euler-Lev analysis. Yeah, sure. But you see, we have stability, boundless solution stability. Mm-hmm. Solution. And also we have uniformly boundless resistance tau. This is important. And this is very nice question. Why I give here table for error analysis? But really, we can get here theorem about convergence difference schemes. And exactly order. First and second order.
Yeah.
Because our results uniformly with respect tau.
Yeah, then the already you have obtained, for example, the error analysis with the convergence rate.
But I show here, like, I will return back.
Yeah, just one example, yeah.
Okay, just example, but also we have, because difficult for us getting these numerical results. These numerical results, because theoretical part, I have nice theorem about boundless solution differential problem, also difference problem. This is uniformly with respect tau. And now using these two results, we can get here theorem, convergence theorem under the smoothness condition for solution. This is important,
Okay. Do you have any other questions or comments?
Yeah, I have one. Dear Professor Allaberen, nice talk as usual. You are very, very good, very performant. Can you think to change the kernel, the power law kernel, into a different kernel and to investigate the Schrodinger equation with or with delay?
Okay, where is delay?
With or with that, but with different kernel, not with the power law kernel.
Here, delay.
Yeah.
About your question, Dimitro, this is very important question for me because a lot of mathematicians work with this delay here, not fractional.
But the problem is with the fractional operator. If you change the fractional operator, can you get the same result? In principle, I mean.
I think here maybe problem with convergence also because here problem with smoothness. So there is must be investigation more. It is difficult.
Yeah, I know.
It is difficult. And why I put here new our paper with Professor Allaberen? Because here we will consider stable difference schemes, first and second order, only for linear problem.
Yeah.
Delay. But nonlinear also may be a problem.
You can also go beyond the Schrodinger equation and try to investigate Bloch-Torre equation, for example, or biological systems, which are system of nonlinear ODE. Then you'll get more, be more involved in the application part. This is excellent results from numerical viewpoint and for applied math. From a physical viewpoint, you know, there is no connection with the reality. So not much connection, but you can give an interpretation. But if you go to other type of equations, which are not based on the conservation laws and physical basic principles, you cannot violate with changing local into non-local because this is a big problem. So then you can repeat the same arguments for other kernels and also for other type of equation of real order. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Dmitro. Very nice question. But as you see, I find for me many problems with mathematical not ending. One day, I remember Kirana asked, when you start this nonlinear problem? Because all time I might talk about linear problem, but linear not ending. Dimitra, here also a problem mathematically.
Okay, then I'd like to conclude this session if you have no more special questions, because now I believe everybody is a bit hungry, maybe.
Okay.
Yeah, then the sincerely, I would like to thank all the speakers for this session, and I hope that Bon Appetit enjoy the lunch.